MSF is working on the front lines of the global refugee crisis. Our teams see firsthand what the impact is when countries close their doors to refugees and asylum seekers. The number of displaced people is a historic high. We haven't seen this many people forced from their home since World War II. Yet our government here in the United States is cutting the number of refugees that can be resettled to a historic low. It means that we're shutting the doors to people fleeing the wars in Iraq and Syria, people who need sanctuary. And at that moment when they need support, the U.S. government has decided to close our doors. Closer to home, we're turning our backs on people who are fleeing extreme levels of violence in Central America. MSF is running programs in places like El Salvador and Honduras, where we see these extreme levels of violence. And then in Mexico, along the route that people are taking to flee and reach the U.S. border. MSF works in some of the most violent war zones in the world today. Yet the experience of our patients in Central America is not dissimilar from what our teams are seeing on the ground in places like the Democratic Republic of Congo, Iraq, and Syria. When I traveled with our medical teams to El Salvador, I saw firsthand the extreme levels of violence that communities are caught in between extremely violent gangs and the law enforcement that are trying to rein them in. I met parents who have to keep their children shuttered inside all day out of fear that they'll be pulled into these very gangs. It's the reason why they're fleeing. It's because they have no prospects of hope for their children. Instead of treating people fleeing from the violence like people who need protection, the U.S. government has been treating them like criminals. What we've seen at the U.S. border is families being separated, people detained in inhumane conditions, people blocked from applying for asylum. These kinds of acts are what drive them into the arms of traffickers that exploit them and bring them across dangerous and precarious parts of the U.S.-Mexico border. These policies only serve to make people suffer more when they've already been through hell to try and reach the U.S. border. In June, the U.S. Attorney General issued an order that essentially closes the door for people to have asylum on the basis of their exposure to gang violence and domestic violence. This is the predominant kind of violence that our teams are seeing in El Salvador and Honduras, and what the people are exposed to along the route in Mexico. So in effect, there is no chance for asylum once this decision was rendered. There's a lot of rhetoric today in U.S. politics around zero tolerance. Well, based on what we've seen, the policies that are being put forward by the current government amount to zero humanity. We hope you'll join us in demanding that the U.S. government upholds the right to seek asylum and stops sending people back into danger. Seeking safety is not a crime.